Will robotaxis be tiny or huge by 2030? At the end of this video, I predict how huge robotaxis will be by 2030 on a scale of 1 to 10. Aisha Evans, boss of Amazon Zoox, is one of many going all out to get you robotaxiing around by 2030. See if you agree with my assessment of the technology, the companies, what's to love, and jobs. What we need to know on technology is whether what's needed will be solved or unsolved. What you'll use to summon the taxi will be solved. You'll use an app just like you do for an Uber. Open it on your phone, enter your destination, confirm pickup and destination addresses, select and then confirm the booking. Waiting time depends on availability, but with fleets of robotaxis driving around in many areas, it won't be a long wait. Designing them so you can jump aboard is also solved. Zoox vehicles are purpose-built for robotaxi work. They look cool. The doors slide open for you to get in and then slide shut with room for four of you and baggage. On arrival, the Zoox opens its doors automatically and you get out. TSLA and Waymo's solution doesn't look as sexy. It's getting in their normal cars. But TSLA's cars are getting pretty impressive, you have to say. Those were the easy bits of tech. Driving you around safely is the real challenge and is only maybe solved. How vehicles see and understand their surroundings before navigating you around the road is a challenge. Combinations of cameras, radar, and LiDAR sensors mounted on all four corners of the vehicles enable them to see in all conditions. TSLA's taking a different technical approach to most, with Elon Musk insisting his teams don't use LiDAR radar and just use optical cameras. Sensors, maps, and artificial intelligence plan and handle the controls in all robotaxis. Amazing progress is undoubtedly being made. There's still a mountain to climb before these vehicles are fully autonomous and safe, though, in a wide range of cities. Some artificial intelligence experts say it's still decades away from being good enough for full autonomous driving in most conditions. Elon Musk and others are far more optimistic. And how are you going to feel about Zoox not having a driver's seat or any steering controls? It's fully autonomous with no human intervention whatsoever, at what's called level 5 autonomous driving. And to make sure it's all safe for you, the companies have to navigate their way through stringent regulations to ensure the vehicles are okay, with over 70 regulations that need to be complied with in the US. I really hope all of this gets solved. Overall, what do I predict about the technology by 2030? I think it really is a case of go Elon. I predict they are going to solve what's needed and will be at the higher end of the scale. A question for you. Do you think much about your life in 2030? There's so much exciting stuff happening. It is hard to keep up. Hit the subscribe button now to get my next weekly prediction. Now let's look at companies. If you will be driving around in robotaxis, it will be because the companies I'm about to show you are in the ring taking the daily knocks that come with getting anything new off the ground. If it's going to be huge, we'd expect to find today that there are already unicorns, startup companies worth more than $1 billion, and plenty of big multinationals active, represented by an elephant here. Are there? Let's see. Zoox is a definite unicorn pushing things forward for you. Born in Senegal, Zoox's CEO Aisha is a notable African-American female CEO. It was acquired by Amazon in 2020 for over $1.2 billion. It shouldn't be surprising that Jeff Bezos would be involved somewhere in robotaxis, all part of his sci-fi childhood dreams, no doubt. And you can see the technology being brilliant for helping with Amazon automated deliveries. Zoox permits to test driverless automobiles on public roads include them operating today in Las Vegas and San Francisco. Elon Musk TSLA is also clearly a robotaxi unicorn. Elon Musk announced the idea of full self-driving robotaxis in 2016. The company was to launch autonomous taxis in 2020. But it hasn't happened. Elon replied to a question on Twitter in 2020 about the launch, saying, "Functionality still looking good for this year. Regulatory approval is the big unknown." If you ask me, TSLA has huge advantages because it can create a robotaxi network using people's existing TSLA cars, creating owners an extra income stream from their car. Plus, Elon Musk has huge amounts of self-driving car data, to give him advantages when it comes to cracking the self-driving nut first. Waymo is also a massive sort of startup working hard for you. The company was founded way back in 2009 and is a subsidiary of Alphabet Inc., the owner of Google, to develop autonomous driving technology. It operates a commercial robo-taxi service in Arizona already called Waymo One. It's the first autonomous service operating without any safety drivers in their car. And there's also plenty of multinational companies that are active, including General Motors and China's AutoX. General Motors is investing heavily. It acquired Cruise in 2021. Their Cruise Origin looks super cool, I'd love to be in one, and is meant to roll off the production line soon. And there's global competition. China is investing massively. AutoX, for example, is testing self-driving cars without human drivers in Shenzhen City, backed by Alibaba. It's easy to imagine China mandating cities before 2030 going fully robo-taxi once they've cracked the technology. So, what's all this mean? It can only mean one thing. All the unicorns and active multinationals points to you riding around in robo-taxis and then being huge by 2030. If you want to dig deeper on these 2030 predictions and have a laugh, book a place on my very popular weekly predictions meetup that happens every Tuesday on Zoom. Use the link in the description, you'll learn masses and it's free. Now, what's all this love stuff? Well, it's the bit where I ask whether you and I have reasons to give plenty of 5-star ratings and not 1-star. For being cheaper than normal taxis and maybe even than owning a car, it scores 5 stars. Today you pay $2 to $3 per mile on a normal taxi in the US. Companies such as Waymo plan to charge 30 cents to $1.70 per mile. Elon Musk noted that Tesla would charge about $1 per mile. This is possible because, unlike normal taxis, robo-taxis don't have drivers to pay or tip. And the robo-taxi vehicles are cheaper to operate because they are electric, easily lasting over 500,000 miles by 2030, compared to a typical gas vehicle that lasts a maximum of 200,000. And are you one of those people robo-taxis are fantastically convenient for and will give 4 stars to? Today there are times when you wait ages for a taxi, even for Ubers. With robo-taxis, it's possible that there will be even bigger fleets of them driving around 24/7 on the roads, with enough being available on demand even at most peak times. It's a dream come true for many to be able to summon a car whenever you need to go somewhere and it swoops up to get you a couple of minutes later. For many, rather sadly in my opinion, is that you don't have to talk to the driver. One more nail in the coffin of a sociable society where we actually talk to each other. You hopefully will be liking the safety and sustainability, giving it 3 stars at least. Today, even though a taxi is generally safe to travel in, it emits 4.6 metric tons of carbon dioxide per year. Aisha Zoox, Elon's Tesla and Waymo's robo-taxis are all electrical, contributing 70% less CO2 than the conventional car. However, the manufacturers cannot guarantee that every self-driving car on the roads can offer the same level of safety and security as a conventional car. Computers may be more reliable and safer than human drivers, but there's still a risk of accidents, and some of us just won't feel safe being driven around without a driver. According to the Highway Traffic Safety Administration, approximately 94% of car accidents occur due to human error every day worldwide, so ultimately it's likely that people will feel safer in robo-taxis than they do in human-driven taxis. I personally think that's what will happen. And something that I think is also fantastic is no more parked cars and will earn 5 stars from many of us. Parking is a major problem in big cities today, causing congestion and taking up huge amounts of space for parking on the streets and in parking lots. Robo-taxis like Zoox mean people don't own cars and instead get a robo-taxi everywhere. This frees up space where parked cars normally clog things up to have play areas and seating and new gardens. I'm not saying I've covered all the pros and cons of robo-taxis, but I think there's enough for you to love that it will be at the higher end of the scale. If you're enjoying this, don't miss out on the next prediction. Hit that subscribe button now. We look at jobs partly because I'm doing Life in 2030 to help people make smart career moves, and you might just see that there's roles you can do. And if robo-taxis are going to be huge by 2030, we should find that already in 2021, lots of jobs being hired and fired. On the fired side, it's not yet happening, but taxi drivers will unfortunately one day be fired. On the hired side, Aisha Zoox's team has a massive 234 job vacancies listed on LinkedIn at the time of recording, which makes it look like things are going to be big. Any of these roles interest you? Technical engineer, recruiter, visual designer, legal counsel, market researcher, financial analyst, among many more. It's well worth looking at LinkedIn if robotaxis are hitting your hot button. Jobs in fast-growing new sectors like robotaxis are exciting and more secure than in older sectors. I was fortunate to join the e-commerce sector with eBay in its early days and have benefited ever since. My Life in 2030 is a course that I run that is perfect for you if you want to think the years ahead through more. To learn more and book a place, click the link in the description below. It really will change your life. Because there are plenty of jobs being hired and one day fired, from a jobs point of view, robotaxis is at the higher end of the scale. Now it's time for me to make a prediction. We've seen the technology needed is maybe solved, there are plenty of unicorns, an overall 4-star rating and loads of new jobs being hired. This means that on a scale of 1 to 10, I predict robotaxis are going to be at the higher end of the scale by 2030 at a 7. To get updates on this prediction, sign up for my weekly predictions newsletter. Click the subscribe button to get my next prediction in a couple of days' time, and go and have a look at this fascinating prediction. I'll see you in the next video.